When a fracture occurs, orthopedic surgeons can place a metal implant in that broken bone. Do these implants need to be removed after the fracture has healed? Which implants are required to remove? If it needs to be removed, when should it be done? You will find answers to these questions in this video. Hi, I'm Dr. Gürkan. In this video, I will explain implant removal from the perspective of an orthopedic surgeon. When there is a fracture in the skeleton, surgery may be required. The surgery aims to allow the bone to heal more precisely and faster, regain functions and return to daily life more quickly. After the broken parts are brought to their functional positions, metal implants fix them. A plate or a long nail, mostly made of titanium or stainless steel, is used. The common name of all of them is an implant. The function of these implants is to hold the bone ends together until the broken bone is healed. If the bone is not healed, the loads that the bone must carry are transferred to the implant. But that implant cannot bear the loss forever. After a while, the implant breaks. This situation is called metal fatigue. As you can see here, if there are bending forces on the metal, it will break after a while. In other words, the bone has not healed if there is a broken implant. This is an entirely separate video topic. On the other hand, if everything goes well, the bone heals 3 months to a year depending on where the fracture is. In this case, the implant's function is entirely over. The fracture healed and the bone took the load again. Theoretically, there should be no problem in removing this out-of-function implant. However, the removal of this implant is a new surgical procedure. This surgical procedure will have a financial and moral burden on the patient, as well as a burden on the health system. We do not perform implant removal as a routine procedure. Sometimes it may be helpful to remove it, and sometimes we do not recommend it because it will not benefit or even harm the patient. However, all orthopedists around the world have a different opinion on this issue. Let me share the results of publications from several countries to give you an idea. In Finland, implant removal is done almost routinely and 80% of the implants are removed. This rate is around 50% in Norway and approximately 20% in the UK. The largest organization in standardizing the principles of fracture treatment and disseminating its education worldwide is named AO. When it was first established in 1958, it recommended that all implanted materials be removed. When this recommendation was made, all implants were made of stainless steel. Since steel is more rigid than bone, there was no flexibility compatibility between bone and metal. This could cause the steel to take the load off the bone and cause osteoporosis and pain in the bone underneath. Most bone implants today are made of titanium. As the biomechanical properties of this metal are so close to the bone, leaving it in place is less of a problem. On the other hand, since the biological properties of titanium are close to the bone, it may stimulate new bone formation and growth during fracture healing. This new bone may cover the plate or screws. As titanium is a soft metal compared to steel, the screw heads may be worn. Another problem is that titanium screws and plates may fuse over time. These are all difficulties in removing the implants. Let's look at who can benefit from implant removal one by one. As a general rule, if there is an infection around the implant for a long time, we no longer have a chance to eliminate the disease here only with antibiotics. The implants inside must be removed entirely if the priority is to eliminate the infection. In elbow and patella fractures, a firm fixation can be made by wires with tension band method. After such a surgery, as the skin is so delicate in this area, putting the elbow on a table or kneeling on the ground is very painful and uncomfortable. It is usually necessary to remove these wires after the fracture has healed. Besides, if the plate and screws placed in the ankle and surrounding fractures cause discomfort during cross-legged, it may be necessary to remove them as well. If the inserted screws penetrate the joint undesirably, it disturbs the joint. In such a case, it may be necessary to remove this implant without waiting for the fracture to heal, or replace it if it has not yet healed. We usually prefer to remove the implants in children's fractures. These children have a long life expectancy. In the future, if there is a fracture in that part of the bone where the implant is used, or if a prosthesis will need to be applied to this area, this implant will complicate the procedure. So we prefer to remove the implants in the children. In some situations, it may be helpful to remove the implants, but we cannot be sure of the result. Let's look at these conditions. In ankle fractures, a screw will be placed temporarily to fix the anatomy if there is a tear in the ligament called syndesmosis. This screw will be removed in a planned manner after 3 months. This method has traditionally been done worldwide. But in some publications, some assert that this screw can be left without removal and can be removed if it hurts. It is also suggested that if the screw breaks, it will not cause a problem and will remain in place. This method is also applicable. Although it is thought that the implant in painful situations may cause pain, there is no method to confirm this. If the implant is placed correctly and there is no problem, it is impossible to be sure whether the pain will go away if removed. In some cases, there may also be a situation that the implant may cause hard to joint movement. It is impossible to prove whether the stiffness in the joint is due to the existing implant unless it is radiologically apparent. Therefore, it is impossible to guarantee whether the pain subsides and functions improve after implant removal. It is recommended not to remove the plates and screws placed in the forearm fractures. The knee fracture rate is higher if the plates are removed. An article published in 2014 found that the probability of a knee fracture when the plate and screws are left in place in forearm fracture is 2.77%. However, if these plates are removed, the likelihood of a knee fracture is 12.9%. In other words, if these plates and screws are removed, the risk increases approximately 5 times. Sometimes, we need to remove the implant at the patient's request due to his obsession with the implant, even though the patient has no problem. It is helpful to remember that the removal procedure may not work without problems. Although there are situations where everything works perfectly, some of the most challenging surgeries in my profession are ear implant removal surgeries. Sometimes, things go oppositely than we want. The hand tools we arrange for removal may be incompatible because the implant is of a different design than we thought. While removing, the head of the screw may be broken due to the metal fatigue and remain inside. The head of the screw may already have been damaged during the initial insertion process. Especially in titanium plates and screws, there may be a possibility that the screw and plate are fused. As the surrounding bone hardens and enters the nail walls, removal may not be easy. There may also be a fracture risk of the bone when removing the implant in a bone that has not fully healed. In addition, it may be challenging to determine the location of the screw heads or the head of the nail to be removed in that bone as the new bone covers the implant. Besides, as I mentioned, the tissue may be damaged during that complex removal operation, and there may be a risk of infection of that damaged surrounding tissue. As I said above, removing the implant burdens the health system and increases health costs. Although there are not many articles on this subject, it was reported in a publication from Nigeria that these patients stayed at the hospital for an average of 6 days and had a burden of $708 per case. This cost will likely be much higher in developed economies. It was also reported that these patients stayed away from school or work 16 days after the surgery. After all, if you still want to have the operations removed arbitrarily, this is a risk you will take. Sometimes patients ask me, if you were in my place, would you have the surgery? If I had an implant because of a fracture, I would not have had that implant removed unless it caused discomfort or the conditions mentioned above. After all, you are having a new surgery, and every surgery has some risks. The complication rate related to implant removal has been reported as 10%. Of these, 36% are wound problems, while the rest are 21% infection, 14% nerve injury, and 12% failure to remove all implants. What is more interesting is that 2/3 of the patients who experienced this complication said that if they had to have this surgery done again, they would have done it again.
This is very strange.
However, if it needs to be removed, it is advised to remove the implants after 1 year, unless there is an extraordinary situation. This will reduce the risks that may occur. But on the other hand, keeping it up to 2 to 3 years will also make it removing difficult. Thank you if you have watched this far. Remember to subscribe and hit the like button for support and not miss my videos with orthopedics, nutrition and sports content. May you have active days where you always smile and do not experience health problems.